This is the first ever transfer of American eels from a dam near Montreal, Beauharnois Dam, to the Ottawa River, just above Carillon Dam, which is near Hawkesbury in Ontario. So it's a great collaboration between Quebec and Ontario governments, Hydro-Quebec, the Algonquins of Ontario here today, and us, the Canadian Wildlife Federation. The eel have declined drastically by over 97%, actually, over the past several decades, basically due to the hydro dams being a barrier to their migration into the rivers and back out to sea. So in the Ottawa, they're particularly at risk and in extremely low numbers. So the idea here is to start a transfer system where we keep a viable number of eels in the Ottawa, but hopefully as we're doing that, we eventually work towards a day where they're naturally returning to the Ottawa River, maybe 10 or 15 years from now.
At one time, these species were integral to the everyday lives of the Algonquins, both physically as sustenance, building materials, medicinal uses and properties that the eel and its body parts held, and as well as spiritually, the eel is seen as a symbol, as being a messenger, able to travel through the waters long distances through both marine saltwater environments and freshwater environments, through wetlands and overland passages. The eel is seen as a spiritual creature moving between two worlds, and for many years and generations that physical contact has been missing or deteriorating with the decline of the American eel.
It's born south of Bermuda, near, kind of in the Bermuda Triangle near the Sargasso Sea it's called. So it takes it a few years to get up to, say, Montreal, maybe 3 years. It's a tiny little thing, just a couple centimeters long when it arrives in Montreal. Then when it starts to come up the Ottawa or go a bit further, it may be 3 or 4 years old, kind of the types of eels you're seeing here today. And it'll go up into the rivers, up into the headwaters, and it may spend 20 years, 15, 20, 25, even 30 years up there, growing to be large. In this area, almost entirely females, very few males here, almost 100% females here. And then once it's decided it's big enough and it's got its eggs ready, it turns around and heads back, basically in 1 year, back to the center of the Atlantic Ocean, spawns somewhere, we're not quite sure where, they're still a mysterious species that way, and then they die, that's it, that's the end of their life cycle, they die out there, and the young then repopulate the rivers again. So this is just an ongoing cycle that's been going on for, you know, actually millions of years.
It's a very monumental day to see that first influx, that first wave of those young eels be helped over that barrier that's been preventing their safe and unassisted passage into these traditional waters.